The Arctic tundra consists of 8 nations. They are Canada, Denmark, which is Greenland, Finland, Iceland, Norway, Russia, Sweden, and the United States. It is an area with 2 million people in it and over 50 languages. One reason that it is very important is because of how it affects the weather patterns in the northern hemisphere.
Unlike the deserts, the Arctic tundra has a long and drawn-out period of winter. The summers are only 6 to 8 weeks in length. Much like the deserts, the tundra has a very dim chance of rainfall throughout the year, making things equally dry.
The soil found in the tundra due to bone-chilling temperatures is frozen solid. This type of soil is commonly known as permafrost. The soil is frozen from 25 to 90 centimeters, 9.8 to 35.4 inches, down, and is impossible for trees to grow.
The agriculture found in the tundra is able to withstand the freezing climate due to adaptations such as a shallow root system. Plants such as the Arctic willow and bearberries use this to help them to avoid becoming plant sickles. Other plants have other more cunning adaptations. For example, Arctic moss has the unique trait of growing in the murky depths of lakes found throughout the tundra.
The Arctic willow is a natural producer of insect repellent, making it able to resist the eating habits of the Arctic woolly bear caterpillar.
Bearberries have a number of uses. Its stem can be used for teas to help women with menstrual problems. Another more conventional use for bearberries is as a tobacco additive or a tobacco substitute.
Arctic moss is primarily used as a natural source of insulation for plants on the lake beds in the tundra's sub-zero temperatures.
In spite of the tundra's lack of rainfall and other necessities for survival, it is home to a variety of animals, some common and fierce, some small and fun to watch, and some that have been the stuff of folklore for centuries.
The small and irresistible lemmings can be found in burrows throughout all of the tundra. It's a small and rather elusive little critter that mainly eats shoots of grass in the brief summer periods and spends the winter eating away at thick bark of trees. Its size and lack of predatory traits makes it a likely meal for the Arctic fox.
The Arctic fox is the prime scavenger of the tundra. It is found in Greenland, Russia, and parts of Alaska and Canada. It mainly spends time looking for things to eat, such as lemmings that are not quick enough to make it to a hiding place, eggs from the nesting grounds of most native birds, and any other small animal that it can find. Like most animals of the tundra, the fox has two coats, a thinner brown coat for summer, and a thick white coat for the frigid winter. Its small size makes it easier for heat to be sent into its body when it's cold. Small ears and furry pads on its feet also make it easier for it to keep it warm while looking for food.
Polar bears are the biggest predators in the tundra. They have thick coats of white hair. Each hair in the coat is hollow to absorb heat from the sun, and its skin is black to increase its heat intake. Its habitat takes up a wide range of the tundra, but its home is constantly shrinking due to global warming. It has the largest number of adaptations out of all animals found in the tundra, such as long claws for grabbing prey, thick layers of body fat to help keep body heat in, sharp jagged teeth for tearing through the skin of seals, insulated pads on its feet, and small ears and tails to minimize loss of heat during the day. It spends most of its time hunting for seals and fish in the freezing waters of the tundra. Perhaps one of the most famous animals living in the tundra is the snowy owl. It's found in the wide open spaces of the tundra and spends the day hunting for lone foxes and rodents along the vast expanse of frozen wastelands. Its white fur helps it hide from the hunters and prey, feathers and thick pads on their feet to keep them warm, and the use of both eyes for hunting making them the most accurate birds of prey in the world.
The narwhal may not be an icon of fear like Baba Yaga, or a symbol of power like Medusa, But its fame has been the stuff of Norse mythology for as far back as the dawn of recorded history. The narwhal is found mainly in the icy waters of the tundra. Its most unique adaptation is the horn on its head, which is actually a tusk growing through its forehead. It shares many similarities to the whale, and is the same nature as their awe-inspiring cousins. It may have the same gentleness as the whale, but it is hunted for its blubber, its tusks, and other such things.
Three of the worst possible threats that the tundra has suffered from humans are destruction of the habitats of countless animals from oil drilling, oil spills from oil liners that contaminate the water, making life difficult for fish and polar bears, and the hunting of animals to the point of extinction. These impacts are one of the reasons why numerous species of animals are becoming more of a rarity, and if not put in check soon, we may never be able to enjoy their majesty, grace, or their inspiring habits in nature.